Hello, everybody.
I'm Joe
Yizhu, and I come from China.
Today, my sharing topic is phishing and online scam in China.
I have been working for China Micro since 2005. At the company, I focus on the Web3 and my role is the architect of Scribble analysis engine, which protects browsers from the exploit attack. Since last year, I also began research phishing in China and try to figure out the difference between Chinese phishing and global phishing. If you are also interested on phishing, so you must know PhishTank. So PhishTank just published a report show only 3% phishing site happened in China. So is it true? Okay, let's hold on this question. Let's discuss another question at first. So what are phishing sites need to be successful? I think it is a user base or population. 5 years ago, we never heard about any phishing site targeted to Facebook. But today, Facebook is one of the most favorite brands of phishers. At the China, we have the biggest population in China. We are almost 1.3 billion. We have half a billion netizens. We have a company named as QQ, just in case you are not familiar. So it is a company of IM and social networking, which has 600 million users, which is almost the same size as the Facebook. For the Taobao, which is similar as the eBay, has 400 users. So many users at the China, so do you still believe only 3% phishing site happened in China? So, okay. Actually, we have some data from the China Micro Web3 protecting system. We found over 100 phishing sites target QQ per day at our system. On the contrast, PayPal reported only less than 100 phishing site target PayPal. So on the contrast, we can conclude the Chinese phishing is more popular than all we can imagine. So in this sharing, I will answer what is the trickiest of Chinese phishing.
I think,
okay.
Let's introduce this hot event. Did anybody hear the?
There is a massive phishing attack which targeted the Bank of China in this February. Some customers of Bank of China lost over $150,000 after they logged into this phishing site. At the February,
500 phishing sites
found which target BOC.
How this happened?
The criminal group will send the SM message at first, tell the customer you need to update the e-token and give some links. If the user opens the link, we are like this snapshot. This snapshot totally copied from the Bank of China, except this. The link behind this image will let the user go to the login page. At the login page, they need to input a username and password and the key from the eToken. What is the eToken? Actually, eToken like this. This is a eToken. It is a device. Bank of China gave this device to his customer, and this key, this eToken will generate a key by random seeds. And it used the RSA algorithm, and Bank of China used this key to identify the user physically. However, the algorithm is okay, but the verification procedure has some problem. The key at the eToken will expire after 30 seconds.
So the, once the hacker gets the information from the web page, they will automatically post those information to Real Bank of China and transfer money immediately. So this story also tells us two-step verification never works. Even we use the mobile phone to replace the e-token and receive some key from the bank, because the bank never know behind the person behind the screen is a fisher or a real customer or a dog. Okay, ironically, so there is also a target attack event to which target RS company. Some hacker send the spear phishing email to the RS company and try to steal the design of eToken. I think if they read the news from the China, so they, I think they just host a phishing site because this make money is more easily. Okay. After having given this introduction, I would like explain Chinese phishing more systematically. I place Chinese phishing into three categories. The first is the traditional phishing site, just like a previous example, Bank of China, or more popular example, Taobao. I will share Taobao example toward the end of sharing. And another category is the fraudulent site. Most of the fraudulent sites don't have any target brands. They just usually happen ticket phishing, which reel the user in and by promising some cheap tickets. And the last category is a scam site. There are a lot of scam. For example, notary scam or stalker scam. What is the notary scam? Typical notary scam flow will be like this. You will receive a message. You are so lucky. You already won a prize. If you follow the link and open the page, so the page will pretend to be our official website and convince you click next, continue browsing. Eventually, at the last page, they will ask you pay the income tax or notary fee before you receive the prize. I think if you paid, but you will never receive the prize. Okay, most of notary scam is leverage some famous brands, for example, QQ or some online game, or CCTV. CCTV is the most watched national TV station at the China, in the China. This guy in the picture is a famous TV show host. His show is a quiz game, and people in this show will receive the prize by answer some question. So the fisher leverage his popularity and let the users believe they can get the prize from this website. So notary scam is quite simple, but the ROI is quite high. Most notary scam is message is phishing message is delivered by the Chinese IM service. For example, QQ or AliWangWang. The later one is the Taobao IM service, which also deliver a lot of traditional phishing site, which target the Taobao. However, QQ and Taobao already do a lot of work to detect those phishing messages. How Chinese hacker handle this problem? Actually, Chinese hacker will compromise some website and inject iframe using this iframe to simulate a pop-up window from the IM message. So this is quite similar, right? So at the China, the phishing is quite get the money easy. And so Chinese hacker prefer deliver the phishing message, not deliver a malicious PE now. Okay, another kind of scam is about stalker and securities. Some hack, if you search some security companies at the search engine, you will find a lot of faked securities. They will promise you can get 100% profit in 1 month if you join their members. But typically is a lie. Most of scam is easy to identify. If you are the person, you believe there is no free things as a free lunch. Okay, but for the fraudulent side, which hard to identify. Both some hack official will buy some keywords. For example, cheap ticket from the Shanghai to Beijing. You may get this phishing site. Both sides share the same template, just the domain name is different. And in the China, for example, during the Chinese New Year, there are almost have 250 million people need to go home. The ticket is quite hard to get. So the ticket phishing is most popular at this time. A lot of ticket phishing sites will appear. Okay, the last section I will share the Taobao phishing. Taobao is similar as eBay. There is $60 billion trade happened in the 2010. The Alipay account is similar as the PayPal, which supports most of Chinese banks. Those is Chinese bank's flags logo. Okay, how these fishers get the money from the victims? Let's view our video. Okay. At the top, if you want to buy something, you may discuss with the vendors. Vendor will give you some detail, for example, color, price, discount, or something, just like that. So some fake vendor will send those fake messages to the victims. This is an order page. If you click the order now, okay. We will go to the charge page. You need to put your password, username and password. Okay, this is a charge page. You will go to the charge page for the mobile phone number. Okay, go to the charge page. This is a password for the Alipay. Same as the PayPal. Okay, if you click now, confirm, your money at the Alipay will lost immediately. But this is not finished yet. The hackers still want to get more money, so they will show the fail to pay message. So you may choose some bank at the below. Okay, this we choose the ICBC, the biggest bank at the China. This is a charge page of ICBC. Actually, this is a fake ICBC. So it's totally copied from the ICBC. Okay, let's see another bank, China Construction Bank. Okay, this is a China Construction Bank. Okay, continue. A little slow. Okay. This charge page is totally copied from China Construction Bank. Okay, so this website is quite professional, right? How do you think it is difficult to build this phishing site? My answer is no. So you can buy the source code from the search results, okay. If you search the phishing source code at the Google, you will find the price is quite low. Less than the price you paid for this event, DEF CON. Okay, only $150. Most of phishing site is copied by template. Actually, I have a copy of Taobao phishing site. Okay. This phishing site, this is a root folder, and a different folder means a different bank.
for different charge page. This is a China Merchants Bank. Okay, some logo for his credit card. How can I get this source code? Actually, we successfully compromised this website. We get the administrator of password for the manager system. Okay, let's log in. Okay, different menu means different bank. Okay, this is a faked, this is a phishing site. Okay, this is a critical number, username, and CC, and we will see the CCV number in the end. Okay. You can, so the back manager, sorry. So the management system is also professional, okay. So that is all today about the sharing. So let me give you a summary. So most of popular type at the China is a scam and a fraudulent site. And notary scam will target some nameless brand websites. And the phishing URL will be delivered by the IM, Chinese IM, Black SEO, and compromise the server. So that's all. Any question? Okay.